It's now time for Mouse Sports and Flipside in a best of one game here for the ESCA ESL Pro League. We just witnessed Flipside get crushed and destroyed by TSM on cash. Doesn't bode too well for them going in against Mouse Sport, who seem like a really, really hungry after their changes, which are quite recent. I would still say they look like a damn strong team and also a really fun team. Different map though, so you never know, maybe this is going to be a bit of a better version of Flipside that we're going to be seeing here on Overpass. They did not look like they had much of a chance on cash though. So we'll see how it goes. Moses has said he's going to join up as soon as he can, but he was just in the middle of something. Then he might try and come and rescue me from all of this solo casting, which would be amazing. But I don't want to, you know, push him too much because he is busy as well. So can't just expect him to show up every time we need him, right? Which would be all the time. He recently actually made the choice to sort of go full-time esports as an analyst and commentator for ESCA, which is super cool. I really like that choice. Definitely a smart idea from his point of view, I think. Mouse Sports, as I said, kind of a different lineup from the one that we've been seeing a couple of months ago. Still sort of a core going on here between Speedy and Gobby and Chris J. But then they brought in Dennis and Nex, and I'm curious to see how it's all going to unfold here for the team. I mean, obviously Dennis and Nex are two really strong players, so maybe not the worst idea. God B is actually a super interesting character and a guy that I enjoy talking to a lot on Steam, because we share a similar passion for just sort of, you know, talking about the game and trying to figure out new things and stuff like that. So we've had some fun times, Gobby and I, just trying to come up with some new things. He's obviously sort of a legendary in-game leader and has a much better understanding of the game. So maybe it's just mostly me who enjoys it, but either way, he's a super friendly guy. Now, they are actually already starting. Great job! We're going to be starting off with the knife round here. Best of one game on Overpass. Flipside, I mean, they could use a win right now. They're going to be playing Hellraisers next, which I imagine is a team they'll be a lot more used to playing against. But remember, they don't have Simple playing here at the ESL League. They only have, as a stand-in, CyberFocus, who admittedly did do pretty well. I mean, I think he was actually better than the most of the team when they were playing on cash, and it still was not good enough. See if they can come with a knife round. They won't be able to. Mouse is going to win it. But again, a big thanks to all of you for joining in once again here and keeping me company as I am solo casting. Semler being stuck in London for the time being. I'm curious. Mouse Sports, did they start? Do you used to start here on the T side? They prefer doing that? I would still say that this map should be a CT-sided map once you figure out how to play it well enough. And actually, they will switch it out. So, yeah, I was a bit surprised if they were going to stick around for it. Let's see. The current meta game on a lot of maps, at least especially the French teams, they seem to favor buying all armor. And as you can tell out here... Oh, I don't like orange. You can tell out here... They've bought three armors this time on Flipside, and two people with the smokes. Now, two smokes like this could be pretty obvious smoke going in towards Bank and in towards the jump-up spot here into the A-bomb site. If you want to go for B, two smokes, it could be enough, or it could not be. The match just paused for a moment, so we got time to fly around and look at things. And the problem is, not many teams have actually come up with really good smokes for this one. But, I mean, obviously you could have a smoke down for the plant here on the site. That seems like the most common thing. Follow-up smoke, secondary smoke could go up to the sniper spot. So it's not like two smokes is useless for B. But it just means you still leave a lot open, right? People could be playing from back here. They could do the boost up here. They could be laying close down on the ramp. There's a lot of spots that won't be smoked off. But we've seen people do it. So this is not like a clear tell. But given the buy, I would guess that this is going to be an A push for Flipside. That's my reasoning anyway, right? And is there anything worse than a caster just trying to cover all the bases and say anything can happen? I mean, if I say anything can happen, then I guess I'll always be right. So maybe that's the approach to take. But I'm gonna put something on the line and just say I think it's going to be an A push based on what they've got going on here. Mouse Sports on the other side. I mean, one of them disconnected. You're not sure what he had, but I guess they got caught sort of mid-buy trying to see what they could do. So far, it's really just Nex and Speedy who need to buy something. Let's see what that is. It could just be all armor on them. I mean, this is... Yeah, so they will. That actually makes a lot of sense for this map, because there's so much range. You're going to be fighting Glocks at, you know, these type of distances right here. You know, it's really long range. And the worst thing that can happen if you're fighting long range against a Glock is they get a body shot in on you. If they do that, then you get impunched if you don't have the body armor, and you might lose the fight. So, better to try and do it like this. And indeed, so far, pushing up towards the A-bomb site. Trying to see if they can make some sort of opening. Speedy has spotted out one person. I like this boost here. Really popular boost now. Dennis, please don't look into the ground. Gotta stay focused, because I think Bondic just managed to sneak by here. I think they're trying to coordinate this one, and what? They end up falling down? Okay, looks like mouse supports are sort of trying to improvise on the fly with what they're doing, which is such a dangerous thing to try and do. Could have got caught by Bondic. Now they're going to go look for him. In fact, take the fight here, but one headshot. Follow-up headshot. Great opening. Now they've killed two at the bomb site. Next, finally going to return with the one kill on Bondic. Bomb all the way back towards the birthday area, and it will now be a 4v3. There's one flashbang going in, a couple of smokes, and they rotate back towards B. But only person holding is Speedy with a USPS, and he has to land some mind-blowing headshots here. Looking for one, looking for more. Not going to get it. This is a big problem for Mousesports. Good fake on flip side's part here. Markov going to take out one. Gets a double kill, in fact. And Speedy, not long for this world. Triple kill on Markov. And Flipside going to win that round and make it look impressive as well. So, yeah. Hard to say if that was the plan all along for Flipside. But getting those two kills, they could either try and run quick towards A, which they probably would have done if they had all been stacked out here. But because the bomb is back here, maybe it makes more sense to fake it and then, you know, take the bomb down instead and run this way. Nice adjustment, I think, for Flipside. I don't think that's what they had planned all along, but, you know, not many rounds survive, like, you know, or not many tactics survive a full round. There's almost always some sort of adjustment, right? Armor on most of Mousesports. Chris, the only exception, might want to be picking up an AWP later on. Markolov actually already getting tagged up here by Dennis. Next is covering from behind, gonna try and run through the smoke like a maniac, but we'll think better of it in the last second. And Markolov trying to play this one as safe as he can, does not want to get picked off. Bondic wants to come up from behind here, will pick off Dennis, but they sort of sandwiched him in a little bit, and that's obviously a smart choice here. Over at long, next will go down Speedy with a one kill. Actually, Chris will get a run over there, no head armor. So MP7, super effective on him. And God B, last man standing, also going to go down here to world edit. So a lot of kills for them. I mean, they had two SMGs, and both of these get a double kill. So a lot of money for Flipside going into the next round, where Mousesports again, and even worse now, will have no armor. So this should actually be Bondic and world edit just running with the SMGs first to try and get as many kills as they can. That should be the tactic here going into the third round. We'll see. World Edit and Bondic here. Are they going to be the two scouts? They're certainly leading the charge right now, which just makes such a lot of sense for them. Might as well get the kills. You're not going to be saving these MP7s for next round anyway. Like, you want to buy an AK when Mousesports are going to have rifles. So, if you die, it's no big deal. Markov clearing all of connector, making sure no one is there. Is there a stack going on over here, or are they all just on top of each other? Dennis is in the bomb site, and we've got Speedy here as well. Actually, they are coming back towards A, so it's going to end up a pretty decent stack back here with Chris, the only one covering B. How much are Flipside going to commit? The problem with stacking this A bomb site, though, is that they don't really need to walk all the way in because the plant zone being extended over here, this new plant is so damn powerful. Bondic now, ready with the MP7. Again, getting these SMG kills is a big deal right now. Bomb goes down. Again, in spite of the stack, just like we just pointed out, doesn't really matter because they can't stop the bomb from going down. Next will pick up a kill. Chris will pick up a kill, which is great news because he's the one buying an AWP later on. But that will be the round. Bondic gets two with the SMG. World Edit saves for an AK, so he actually doesn't have to buy one. A lot of money here on the CIS team. And there we go. Chris with the AWP, everyone else on an M4, and the fourth round is coming up. Now, let's see what Mouseports can do, because they're going to have to try and contest him. I feel like lately, the best rounds that we've seen, the best play that we've seen CT side on Overpass, is the one where it's kind of like what Mouse are doing now. You end up fighting in this area of the map instead of on the actual bombs. Coming out here, Goppy trying to buy time. Speedy gonna get the one kill there, but Goppy's playing in the smoke right next to the pillar in front of him. Blade tries to put down the bomb, and Goppy's gonna stop it, jumping back down. That's a great move right there, essentially a round winning move. World dead to pick off Chris J, but Bondit coming in from the side is gonna catch Goppy. Reloading goes for a second one, can't pick up next, and World dead it very low on health in a 1v3, and there's no way he's gonna lose this unless they feed themselves to him one at a time here, and they won't. That was, I mean, Speedy and Nyx got the double kill, but that move from Gobby probably was round winning. That's going to be 3-1, and a good comeback from Mouseports once they get rifles. I do like the change of pace anyway from Flipside. Just trying to see if the first round where Mouseports buy, they're somehow going to get caught off guard, which they very nearly were. Imagine if Speedy dies early, or if Gobby doesn't get the kill on the guy planting the bomb. All sorts of bad things will happen. Flashbang on over. Chris not flashed at all, and actually, sorry, Dennis not flashed. Going to pick up the kill. Does trade, and Chris back here. Got to be a little bit careful. We'll end up falling back. World Edit being out there shooting away. Bomb just being dropped by Bondic down here, so really trying to take their time. Not feeling too much pressure at the moment on Flipside. Ooh, Speedy. If he could catch a kill on Cyberfocus, that will give up so much of the round for Flipside, because then they'll know that there's not much else going on. Cyberfocus staying alive and keeping these two people occupied is a big win if you're on Flipside right now. Chris gonna walk on out. Does get the shot through the wall. World Edit down to 19 health. It's a bit of a cheeky angle. Chris J is actually gonna burn alive, and Gopi winning the fight here. So now the game is up. They know that this is definitely an A push coming out. Next gonna jump up. The flashbang is perfect. And Bondic to fall next. World Edit low from the earlier shot. Ends up dropping. They save the AWP as well. Great round for Mouseports. That's two in a row where they only lose two people. And that means they're out of money on the terrorist side. They just don't have the economy to sustain it, sadly, from them, because the first three rounds were impressive. They got all those SMG kills, but the last two rounds, I mean, they got the bomb down in one, but on this one, and they've lost two in a row. It's going to put them on an eco. Playing it fairly safe here, Chris. Some AWPers will like to run up to the stairs where the smoke is currently up to try and get that shot in. And I like this low overlap. Look at this. Dennis going to turn around. Will get overrun eventually. The Tech 9 a little bit too much. But he was there for his teammates. Although Chris will go down. This is way too expensive of a round right now for Mouseports. Giving away a lot of openings right now to Flipside. Will lose the bomb and the AWP. Cyberfocus still doing damage. This round is more effective than the previous two where Flipside had rifles. So that's a little bit scary. Orp going to be saved? Yes, it will. So 3-3, score is tied, but that one dug deep into Mouse economy. They survived with only two members, and you can tell Chris and Nex here, they have the money. Obviously, Chris doesn't need to rebuy an AWP, but he's going to buy an M4 for a friend, so he's going to be super poor as well. Wow. Really just got B with a decent bank. And in the underpass now, it's going to be a bit of a battle here. Grenades raining on in. Dennis ready and waiting for Markolov. Can't really see a thing though, and neither can Nex. So they're just shooting blindly. Markolov taking a couple of shots through there. Gotta be careful with that AK. And look at the flashbang out. The timing from Dennis. Very nearly perfect. He did a lot of damage to Blade as well. Spotting out a couple of people, and Blade will go down. What a weird round from Flipside. Almost felt as though that whole round fell apart as soon as Markolov went down in connector. Which obviously you cannot really bank a whole round on just that one guy. He goes down, they open the door, catch the boost out there, and everything falls apart. Now it's on World Edit and Bondic to try and see if they could somehow steal this one back. Almost requires a bit of a miracle here. Great position from Gobby, just waiting for it. Are they going to show their faces first? He must be able to see. Oh, but they knew that was coming. World Edit, you can see, clearly pre-aiming that one. Bomb attempted to be planted here. In fact, it's going to get disrupted as World Edit. Oh, and then Chris J catching him mid-air. Good kill from World Edit on next, but that was unfortunate. He just wanted to see what was going on the other side. No bomb plant, no round win. Four rounds in a row for Mouse Sports, but they are expensive rounds at least. An armorless round coming up from Flipside here. Pistols, Tech 9, deal on World Edit. Always enjoyable to watch. And a really aggressive move here from Chris. Not with the AWP, with the M4. A good early pickoff here. Needs maybe to fall back or a little bit of backup. He's got Nex here with him as well, so they can stand and fight if they want to. But they're really trying to play this as safe as they possibly can, and they're getting some great shots in. Finally, Chris is going to get caught, but as long as they can survive with three here, that'll be good. Nex is going to fall, though, so they are still losing way too many members in these rounds. What makes you wonder, after the initial pickoff, should they have continued to fall back? Chance that Bondic will actually win this round is somewhat limited, but it's not impossible. Problem is, for him to guess that Speedy's going to be here is not going to be easy, unless he somehow just happens to find himself walking up behind him. Is he going to turn for it? He does go down. Speedy, can you smell it? Can you feel it? It's coming out from behind. This could be the move. He's going to be right there, and that's an easy pickoff. And now there's a real shot here. Bondic with the triple kill. Got B. Trying to get in towards the bomb site here. Is he going to catch him? Oh, he's got the angle for it. Bondic, he's on the site. I don't think God B realized just yet. Bomb goes down. Flash peek out there. Knows exactly where he is. And God B not wasting any time. Bondic looking for the quad, but not going to get it. Gets headshot, and with no armor, that's an instant kill. So much tension, and then not the final release there for Bondic. Sadly, it's a great round for him. That would have been such a clutch, but Gopi's going to steal it away, making it 5-3. And a very hard time here for Flipside, although this time they most definitely had the money. Oh my god, they've got a lot of money. Now let's see. Current score is 5-3, and we're moving into the ninth round. Double up setup, just like we saw on Cash when they were playing T-side. They only really had one round where they found a great opening, but this time we don't have to wait very long before CyberFocus is going to open up on Speedy, and that is an important kill to start off with here. Got B, with just a 5-7 in hand, wants to go and pick up that rifle. A little bit scared that he's going to get picked off in transition, but he could do it now and get away scot-free. How far are we going to go? Oh, there's Chris going to be picking off Marco. Oh, sorry, World Edit. And Dennis going for the spray through. Got to be really careful with that AK on the other side. Currently a 4v4 situation, and still plenty of time for Flipside to find an opening. Blade and CyberFocus, they are a little bit softened up. Gopi's going to flash out and run the other way. Bit of a tricky move there. They're getting down here with the bomb. Nice Molotov over towards the barrels. No one currently holding there, but still means they don't have to check it. And Dennis playing on this slope. Just looking for some sort of opening. 30 seconds left now. Flipside have to make a move, otherwise they're going to run out of time eventually. More grenades raining in and more trading. Dennis is going to pick off Markolov. Now it's on Bondic and Blade. And Blade puts down the bomb. Big victory there. Bondic to save him. Nice teamwork coming out right now for Flipside. Blade goes down though. And now it's on Bondic. Last time it was on him to try and clutch it, and he nearly did. This time he has to come through for his team. He sprays one. Gobby goes down. 16 health left. Just trying to dodge. Duke and dive here, but Chris is going to steal it away. Triple kill and a headshot from the USPS. And one more round stolen away here. Wow, it's getting really, really tough right now for Flipside. All right, with a little bit of luck, we may actually have Moses joining us any second now. At least we're trying, at least we're trying. Flashbang on over. And Chris gonna take an aggressive peek. This is the one we were talking about earlier that you can sometimes do. But staying around for a long time is dangerous because people can obviously sort of circumvent you and go around the other way. So you got to be careful. Speedy goes down. That's another time where he actually loses the entry. Last time he did it as a Cyber Focus. This time he got taken out by Blade. So these entry frags, they should be what spawns more round wins for Flipside. But in fact, they don't right now. Next going to try and fall back. They don't want to fight World Edit with the AWP over there. Although they could have probably overwhelmed him. But a little bit scared. Four v five at the moment, and Dennis trying to sneak on up. Right around this wall, Cyberfocus is hiding, so could be a bit of a battle if somebody from Mouse goes to actually check it out. But it feels like they're going to be making their way towards that A bomb site. So you got to wonder what Cyberfocus is going to be doing down there. If he's going to backstab them, or set up for a bit of a fake next to take out Bondnik, that P90. Still super effective. Chris trying to jump over. Can't see anyone. Dennis with a pick off there. And now Markolov alone trying to cover the bomb up here. Gotta be careful. Next will take him out. And now they have a one-man advantage. Not a lot here because Next is so low, but they're going to extend it a little bit. Dennis getting that kill. World Edit had one chance to get that flick through and not going to be able to. So there it is. Now seven rounds in a row for Mouse Sports. And this time they have a lot more people surviving. Just going to try and see if I can get Moses on the server with me here. That would be amazing. But if not, we'll come up with something else, guys. I promise. Should be possible. Just give me a second here. I think we may have him on. Chris with the AWP and Dennis with the AWP. So it goes from Flipside having the double orb now to having Mouse Sports with two of them. We know how dangerous that could be. Not too often that we get to see Dennis doing the orping, but it's definitely cool to see it now. Dangerous for both sides here. Grenades exchange as a follow-up, and spray on through. Cyberfocus not going to connect too much, although Gobby did take a little bit more damage than Cyberfocus, so I guess that was worth it at the end. Now let me see. Hey, Moses, can you hear me all right?
Yes, I can. How's it going?
Perfectly. It's going wonderfully. I think I'm just going to turn your volume down just a tiny bit so that you're not too loud. There we go. I think that might be all right. But guys in the chat, let me know if it's going to be too loud still. Thank you so much for joining me, Jason. You're amazing.
No, absolutely.
So did you manage to connect onto the server as well?
Yes, yeah, I just saw last round as my first round, so...
All right, well, you get a bit of a chance here. Just to catch you up, Flipside did get destroyed on cash by TSM, and they've just lost seven rounds in a row to Mouse Sports here. They've only won the pistol and the other two following up rounds, so it's been a bit of a tough evening for them so far. And actually now they're going to be trying to push into this B-bomb site. Dennis, though, getting entirely flashed. Definitely a good pop flash there. And then World Edit to take out. Chris J. Speedy will get finally return kill. Gobby goes down. This is the kind of action that they were looking for. And now Nexus alone, you know, 1v3. And there's a little bit of lag going on GoT. I'm not sure why that is, but hopefully it'll clear right up. Nex trying to see if he can clutch a 1v3. Definitely not lacking in bravery right here, but he's going to get picked off by Blade. And that will be the round, 7-4. So what do you think, Moses? Decent round from Flipside. Some pretty good entries there.
Yeah, it really was, and that was the key, was those entries. The last couple rounds that I had seen, they were very spread out across the map. They even had a man advantage one round, and they didn't find any way to take advantage of having that player advantage. So that round, they just kind of hit that bomb site, and those entries just opened it up really, really nicely.
Well, now they've got four Molotovs, and Mouse Sports, actually, I mean, this is incredible, isn't it? They've won seven rounds in a row, and they lose one round, and they're on an eco. So that also tells you, I guess, that Flipside have been pretty close for a while now. They just haven't been able to connect the last ones. Chris will pick up the one kill here. Blade in some trouble. The flashbang is perfect from Speedy. Does get the weapon, but can't really fire it quick enough here. Markolov will pick up one, and Well, they've stolen two AKs. Flip side, if they crumble now, that'll be horrendous.
Yeah, now it gets scary. And Markolov does grab that one, but they're pretty much forced into this B hit now through the long sewers through Monster.
Wow. That kind of opening from Chris is hard to deal with. The other two are on the bomb side as well. Bondic and Markolov, they have to come up with something big here. They've got the time to take the fight, but they need to land a shot right now. Nex will go down. Chris will go down. And God, B is close here. USPS in hand, trying for a bit of a James Bond mission. Not going to work out. Markolov with a triple. That was a nice save from the two remaining members then. That was a really scary situation.
It was. There were so many angles they were being pinched from. So that was really, really nice control by those guys to clean all that up. And just very scary. You know, you said it when you talked about Mouse had won seven rounds and forced to save. Three of those rounds came to one-on-ones, like right in a row there. Rounds 7 through 9 were all one-on-ones, which is crazy.
Yeah, that doesn't happen too often, does it? I mean, that means you're right at the edge. I guess maybe Flipside haven't been panicking for those rounds. They've just been thinking, one more shot and we're going to make it work. Nice boost up, but Cypher Focus. He crouched in to pre-fire that one, and it works out beautifully for him. Now, they're not really speeding up. I mean, this is actually something that Flipside have been doing all along. They drop the bomb really far back, so even if they get great entries, either they're really patient, but even if they wanted to speed up behind it, they kind of can't because they don't have the bomb there.
Right. That's actually very interesting. You're exactly right. And there's another kill by World headed onto Chris J, so they've got a two-man advantage here. But yeah, no matter what happens, they're forced to run so far back to pick up that bomb. It almost forces them to play things a little bit patient and slow things down in the mid-round.
Yeah, and it's hard to know. I mean, sometimes it could be a big benefit. Sometimes, obviously, it could really mess with you. But so far, I mean, it seems to have actually worked out pretty well for them. Even though it certainly denies them one aspect of the game here. And once again, they do this where they leave one person lurking at B. That also has been a very popular style for them. And then they rotate over towards the A bomb site. So Blade is rotating, making some noise here. But I think actually Mousesports have caught on. They've realized this is happening and they're going to try and defend this bomb site. Next, trying to spray down. He's going to end up dropping to Bondic. And now Speedy close here. Can't see a thing. He's right next to the SWAT truck and ends up getting a kill on World Edit. But the bomb still goes down. And so will he. So now a 1v3. Flipside really coming back to this game here. And Gob is going to run away.
Yep, that round they were able to take the 5-on-3 and turn it into that win, and it was a very slow mid-round again, and you're right, I think Mousesports is going to start catching on to that, because Speedy actually got a nice jump onto it, even though there was pressure being put on that B site, so he actually got over to A really quick. There was just, you know, just too many smokes in those choke points, and already being down two members, it's so hard to kind of come back from that, and that's sort of a hit, so Flipside really has picked things up here.
What do you think about that new bomb plant up at the A bomb? So I say new, but obviously in the latest iteration of the map, yeah. Those two boxes, it seems to be just so powerful.
I love it, to be honest.
Oh, you're a big fan of it?
Yeah, I like it a lot. Well, because remember how it used to be played where, you know, when LDLC won their major, it was just like smoke off the entrance and just sit back behind it. It felt very like Inferno B bomb site where you're just playing behind smokes for 45 seconds to a minute and a half and... That just kind of got a little bit stale, and I think this gives more opportunities to terrorist teams to pick things up.
I mean, so as many of you may have noticed, I've had like a war going on against default planting for a while now. I feel like planting default, obviously there's a reason for it, and that spot behind the boxes is like the most default right now on this map by a really wide margin. But I'm wondering if we're going to start to see CT sides, essentially almost, I mean, it's almost to the point now where you could just let someone walk on the bomb site to try and plant and then just double or triple grenade them. Like, you could probably come up with some really easy grenades to explode anyone trying to put the bomb down here. So, that's what I'm worried about with people using that box so much.
Yeah, that's just how responses to the meta go, and you're right, that's something that we should see. Oh, a couple nice kills here from Mouse. That's a third one from Gob, so this is a scary situation now for Flipside.
Yeah, they're going to lose Blade as well. Markolov, the only one covering here in a 1v2. He does have a Molotov to buy time. But Speedy has a kit, so they can actually wait out the Molotov a little bit here. Good headshot. Speedy goes down as well. And Markolov to save it. That was right on the edge. Mousesports making the absolute most on the round, but not good enough here. So 7-7. What an unlikely game. That's three rounds in a row for Flipside, seven in a row for Mousesports, and another four in a row for Flipside.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. You know, when you lose so many rounds in a row to one versus ones, you don't really generally panic. You know, it's really unfortunate, but you're saying, you know, the things we're doing is working. You know, the strats we're running, they're not designed to, like, win rounds. They're designed to get you into those late round situations that you need to win from there with good play. And so they're getting into these one-on-ones, and they've just kind of stuck with it because it's obviously getting them to the late stages of the rounds with a shot to win.
See if Mousesports are going to try and change something. I mean, I guess this is actually a map where doing CT side aggression could be a little bit tricky because you're already pretty far away from the other bomb side. So if you start walking out, let's say you walked out of B to check, I mean, if something happened at A, you would be so far away that it would essentially be too late. So you could still get a lot of information, but it seems like the most aggressive moves that we see right now involve pushing up towards birthday area and sort of pushing up by picnic as well. But you don't really see teams venturing too much into the T side of the map apart from that. So still Mousesports just playing this one pretty safely.
Yeah, and that actually surprises me because, you know, just to bring up that plant spot you talked about, one of the ways to really defend this A bomb site is to get aggressive in these bathrooms. You know, that's a spot where there's so many tricky angles that you can find a pick or two and then retreat towards the bomb site with the man advantage. And haven't really seen Mouse do that because it's an area that can be so difficult for terrorists to clean out efficiently.
Yeah, I mean, I think a couple of earlier rounds they tried and they actually ended up getting shut down a lot. So maybe they're just playing off of experience and thinking, well, we haven't really been able to win too many fights there. Let's stop doing it. Bomb down, though, and Speedy with a great double kill here. Very nearly a triple headshot onto Cypher Focus, but he takes out two before he goes down. And now Dennis gonna fall to Markolov, Chris J alone. This is the 15th round and there's just enough time for the plant. That's ridiculous. That was 3 seconds left here for the bomb to go down. Chris is going to be walking in, trying to clutch this, and Markolov hiding in the smoke. Very smart, in fact. I mean, what does Chris J do here? Grenade won't kill anyone. He's got no kit currently picked up. Great headshot on World Edit, but Markolov, look at this play right here. I mean, Chris has got no chance. This is already over. Chris just hasn't realized yet. He's going to be walking in. An easy pickup for Markolov there. 8-7, and it ends up being in favor of Flipside. And then the game crashed real quick, so we'll be right back into it.
Yep.
Don't worry, guys. We're not going to miss anything.
But what a comeback. Like an adjustment. Whatever they did, whatever they changed there towards the end, I mean, even if it's just winning those one-on-one battles, Flipside turns it around huge there at the end.
Yeah, that was definitely very impressive. Really, really happy we got to see that. Because it was, I was getting worried for a moment. I thought, okay, we're going to see another awful game where Flipside get crushed just like they did by TSM. But definitely looking a lot more solid here on the T side of Overpass. Good news.
Well, they were just, you guys started a little bit late, so they were maybe just trying to help you out, get you back on the time schedule.
Yeah, exactly. We did actually make that joke that was what TSM was up to, so it certainly worked. I mean, we're almost back on track here, so not too bad. How does it feel, Moses, when you're playing evenings like this is in a team? You know, they've got 3 best of one games tonight, Flipside, against 3 different teams. So, I mean, you could either have a great evening where you sort of, you know, it feels good. Or I suppose, especially because they're best of ones, you could have like a really upsetting evening where you just lose all the games and you never get a chance to change much because you're playing best of one games.
Well, I'll tell you that getting beat the way they did to get, on cash against TSM that badly, I mean, that's... You'd think it would be rough to come back from that, but those huge losses are sometimes just easier to bounce back from because you're like, all right, we just got crushed. You know, it's not like we made too many mistakes in these situations. You know, if they were to lose this match now, that's when it starts to get hard, when you have a close match going into the second half where you feel like you have the advantage. And if you drop the ball a little bit, that's where the struggle comes in going into your third map.
All right, well, I mean, I can definitely follow that logic. So they don't seem too bothered by it. Flipside, they certainly showed up in this match here. So whatever loss they had against TSM, maybe it's just washed right off. If you are just joining us, then a big welcome to all of you here. This is the ESCA ESL Pro League going on. Best of one game between Flipside and Mousesports. Second half coming up, and we're on Overpass. And I have Jason with me, Jason O'Toole, better known as Moses, or from the ESCA stream. Moses, you recently went full-time esports, which, in my opinion, is a super great idea. I really, really want to thank you for helping me out here. It's, you know, it's you're a savior tonight, essentially.
Oh, absolutely. Always a pleasure. Glad we got to get to find this chance again after ESCA, because that was a really cool.
That was enjoyable,
be able
wasn't
to hang out and cast with you and Semler there at that tournament. That was fun.
Yeah, we had a really good time as well. Should do it more if it wasn't the fact that the States is just a little distance away, but otherwise we'd be there all the time, right?
That's why we have the internet. Just throw up the Moses signal whenever you need me, Anders, and I'll come running.
All right, I appreciate that. I'll definitely take you up on that offer in the future. Well, we've got the second half now starting off in a very similar style from Flipside here. It's four armor and then one guy with a defuse kit. So nothing special. Mousesports, trying to think out, what did God B have? Did he have grenades that he's already thrown out? Because nobody else has a pistol. He's not bought for anyone.
Yeah, he did.
Alright, so he's already used a couple of his grenades. Speedy still has his, and they are set up outside of B, but they've lost Chris J already. Cyperphotica's winning that fight, so I don't know. I mean, they are pulling people back towards the A bomb site. Only World at it down here, so whatever is going on definitely seems to be working.
Yeah, it almost seems a little bit interesting read. I wonder what Flipside saw. I know that smoke that got be used was used to smoke off in that B bomb site short, yeah. Right next to the bomb site to block off the short view from where World Edit's standing.
Oh, and look at the smoke. It's actually an incomplete smoke bomb onto sniper spot. Markolov is now using this as a one-way smoke with his USPS. Is he going to be able to see through spots a couple of people? They are firing bad again, so they realize that something is up here. And Dennis is going to win the one fight. World Edit with the reply, and bomb goes down. But Flipside are not in a bad position here. They've got the time to try and get back onto the site. Markolov with a great pickoff. Dennis and next, they're going to have to work some real magic here. And already starting off here with a nice headshot. Next finding a second one. And this is not looking good right now for Flipside. They got to be careful. Dennis will pick up one next with a third headshot. We wanted magic, and I think we just saw it. That's crazy.
Yeah, that's a really nice hold, because I actually like a lot what Flipside did there. You know, it looked a little bit like a misread, but the rotations between these two sites are so quick, so they just trust their team with a man advantage to be able to win that retake situation, and it almost works out for them. But like you said, just the magic out of Mousesports there with some nice headshots, they're able to close that down, but a very cool tactic from both teams, really.
Yeah, absolutely. It's got to feel really bad for Flipside, though. I mean, they had a really good run at the end of the first half, and they probably feel like that second half belonged to them. They do have the jumping scout back here by Cyberfocus, which has been the topic of so much discussion recently, but I'm glad. And he's going to be playing the scout king in Chris J back here. You got to be really careful with that. Chris could have landed that shot. It went into the light pole. I think that light pole just saved Cyberfocus.
That was really scary for Cyberfocus.
Is there like a... Yeah, there's the bullet hole that saves Cyperfocus. World Edit, though, will get a headshot on Speedy, so maybe Flipside could bring it back here. That is crazy.
Those light poles.
Yeah, I think they actually do absorb, like, all the damage if you're shooting with a scout as well. Or someone should go and test that, but I've got a feeling that they do.
They're made out of adamantium, the Wolverine's bones.
Exactly right. Oh no, there it is. Chris gonna finish him off finally. Cyperfocus is going down now. They want to push on here, and they're not waiting a lot, but they gotta be careful. There are people back here. Bondic with a double killer now, close range. Oh, Chris getting great round from Flipside, really. And I mean, we were talking about the virtues of having the bomb but far back, so that when you get an opening, you don't necessarily just rush on it. You kind of, you know, you spend time thinking, is this the right move? Mousesports almost did the opposite, right? They got that one opening on Cyberfocus, and they just made the call to go.
Right, and actually, once again, Flipside just played that really well, and it's actually, for someone like me, I cast all the North American games, so I get to watch the mistakes the North American teams make on their anti-ecos, but Flipside there, you could see, they really, like, baited that hit in. They really sucked Mousesports into that hit, and every step of the way, they would have a crossfire or, like, a bait-and-switch setup, and they really lured him into that A-bomb site where they just had one more crossfire that does everything, and obviously, Bondic with the 5-7 being a huge hero there.
Yeah, that was a nice double kill. Cyperfocus has taken a lot of damage already, and Mousesports have sort of forced up in return here, but that's a good headshot from Nex, actually. Flashbang on in, but it's too late. Bondic had sprayed down both Dennis and Gorby by the time that flash landed. Nex to get one kill, could get a second one here. In fact, a third one with the Tech-9 steals a Galil, and is now going to be fighting World Edit. Does do a hell of a lot of damage, but it's still going to be all on Chris here. He's got so much time, though. I mean, he could run wherever he likes. Scary round for Flipside, even though it looks like they might win it.
Yeah, but like you said, he has a lot of time. Actually, Flipside, maybe they know he has a scout, but they're playing this really, really well to go up against the sniper. No one's even close to giving up a peek that would let Chris J... I mean, they're luring him into these close-range fights, And World Edit's going to come up the stairs. And Chris J just turns the wrong way, but Markeloff and World Edit timed that perfectly. No matter who won that first duel, the second Flipside member was going to pick it up. So nicely done by them.
Definitely very important there. Did it seem to you like the timing between next flashbang and Gobby and Dennis pushing in was just a little bit off? I mean, I guess maybe it wasn't like it was just like an instinctive play on everyone. So, I mean, next just thought now is the good time to flash. And it would have been if they had just been 2 seconds further back, I think.
Yeah, it could have been. And that might be just, I mean, this is that new Mouse Sports lineup. They've only been together for what, like 2 weeks or so, yeah. I want to say. I mean, that's just a very small miscommunication probably, so...
Good pick off there, and that's Scout versus AWP, and actually Mousesports forced up once again. That's a bit of a stretch, isn't it? I mean, that's two rounds in a row where they don't just like even out the money, they actually just full force here.
Right, well, they're trying to keep the pressure on the economy, and actually they do take out World Edit, but you're right, there's a lot of work to do, so this force buy isn't going to do much, but yeah, I mean, you look at last round, they got it down to two people, the round before that, they got it down to three. They wanted to keep at least economical pressure, they probably wanted to get at least two more kills minimum that round, so that they can keep the money low, so that eventually when they do win a round, they just fully break the economy, but it doesn't work out for them at all, so a little bit of a gamble, and now they're going to be forced to have a full save. And we're seeing a lot of that recently. Actually, Mousesports did that under Gabi at ESCA against Fnatic on Mirage. They did the exact same thing.
Yeah, I mean, maybe backfiring just a little bit here, but what's the saying? No bounce, no play. I guess they have to take a risk every once in a while, right? They gotta say if they can just switch it up a little bit. Could have worked out. I mean, that's how Flipside got back into the first half, wasn't it? They lost seven rounds in a row, but because all those rounds were so close, they still end up having a pretty good first half here. Flashbang's going over, and Cypher Focus trying to run away. Oh no, he can't see a thing. He ends up stopping in the middle of the lane. That's madness. Goes for the repeat with four health. Cypher Focus, what are you doing? He's only getting one more kill here, but that's a huge risk. Goes back for a third one, and Moses, you can only keep doing that for so long until you're going to get punished.
Yeah, the ball's on that guy, but part of it too is where do you fall back from there, because you fall back over towards bathroom and you could have players wrapping around you easily, so he probably just felt like his only real chance was to peek somewhere, and he did end up getting two, which is about the best you can do, but there's Chris J taking out World Edit. Still two more rifles to deal with over here, and Bondex just going to clean both of them up, but yeah, it's a little bit aggressive, but like I said, there's just not really any safe place to fall back if you get caught out like that, so that was actually really well done by Mousesports.
Yeah, it's something that a bunch of teams have been struggling with playing this lane. I think right when this change to the bomb site was made, we saw a bunch of people who were holding in a position where they were sort of looking towards restrooms and also towards long. So they were kind of covering both lanes at the same time, which obviously doesn't make a lot of sense, but people tried anyway. And it still feels to me like people haven't fully figured out how to play that on the CT side. Like no one has really come up with like the best way of holding it is just kind of left open right now.
That's why I think, in my opinion, this map, it's so crucial. You know, position that Blade's playing in, he's going to get spammed down here. But in these bathrooms, especially if you have a talented AWPer who can hold some angles, that's a place where the CT team can find a pick and they're able to fall back relatively safely or even readjust to try and go for a second pick. So I think the bathrooms are crucial on this map.
Ooh, nice holdover and long here. Cypherfocus coming out of bathrooms just in time to pick up God B. And now Bondig is sneaking closer here. This is a little bit dangerous. Going to be a flashbang on in. Actually, almost a little bit annoyed they threw that flashbang, because I kind of wish Bondig would just keep pushing here. And a flash like that could give it up. Although, yeah, you see Dennis sort of turning around waiting for it. Bondig now going to be sneaking in. Dennis right on the other side. But he's going to go back in time. Bondic caught the edge of him, and now he's right on their tails. Oh no, Mousesports. They could lose the bomb right here if they're not hurried. They're trying to get down. There's the bomb dropped. It does fall down the stairs, though. And World Dead is going to pick up Chris as well. So this is just falling apart for Mousesports here. Flipside are now getting close to winning this map.
Yeah, very, very well done. You're exactly right. That flashbang might have given it up, but... He doesn't peek with it, but he has found that timing. So this strategy for Mousesports, the slow play over towards B, has just been absolutely annihilated here. And they're actually just stuck, and the time's going to run out. So they're just going to get bull rushed after the timer. I mean, this is very scary for the economy of Mousesports.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. They're stuck in a spot where there is no escape at all. Markeloff trying to spray through. They will actually miraculously survive. I was sure they were going to lose that.
Yeah, I'm really surprised that Flipside didn't go for that at the end there, or at least, you know, put a little bit more pressure on them. That's a little bit interesting, but regardless, they don't get the money anyways. They do keep the guns.
Yeah, it's a sort of consolation prize almost. And I mean, at least the rest of Mousesports can still force up here, even though it's not the most impressive force up either. So we are going to be moving into the seventh round of the second half right now, and it's time to win. Like, now Mousesports need to gain a little bit of traction here, otherwise they're gonna end up crumbling. Bondic there pushing up to take down Nex, very annoying, and then they fall back and play it safe, which is what I'd like to see from Flipside here. Although, maybe not safe enough, I think Bondic wanted to hang around a bit.
Yeah, but if he could have gotten that second one, that would have been amazing. And that's you know, what you're talking about. You look at how he got that opening pick, falls back, and finds a location to get a good shot for a second pick and just couldn't land it. Dennis, though, another entry out of the A site. So all of a sudden, it's a 4-on-3 advantage and a must-win round for Mousesports.
Sneaky position from World Edit. We'll pick up the kill on Speedy. And we're back into a 3v3. They're pushing two people along, and Dennis is coming up from the restrooms. Markolov holding in a good angle here with Cypher Focus on the other side. They've got Molotovs and everything else. Smoke goes off for the plant, and Markolov actually has a Molotov. He's going to put it out as well, and buying a little bit of time here. He's going to get dropped. Dennis will get a headshot. 35 seconds left, and where is that bomb plant there? Cypher Focus picking off one. Finally, the fire has disappeared, and they can put down that bomb. One grenade out, and now it's on World Edit and Cypher Focus. They could practically close out the game here if they win this round. Mousesports have almost no chance at all. There's a grenade on out, but Chris has moved just enough out of the way that he's going to stay alive. Cypher Focus missing a shot here, still gets the kill. And Dennis now has a triple. He's going to have to go for an ace here. He's going to have to go all in. Bomb. Cypher Focus is on it with the kit. There's the one shot in. World Edit now alone in a 1v1 versus Dennis, who's got the quad kill, looking for more. Sprays down. Can't get the kill, but will still win the round. Mousesports finally connect.
Very, very patient play by Dennis there. Very good round from him. He pretty much abandoned Chris J in that site. Or not abandoned, but he was just like, okay, I'm playing the bomb. You're on your own. You know, do what you can, Chris. And if that retake had been a little bit faster from Flipside, they took a lot of time trying to find Chris J. But did you notice Markolov actually did what you just said? He just throws that Molotov on the default plant spot and is like, all right, guys, wait 7 more seconds for my teammates to get here, please.
Yeah, I'm super happy to see that. I definitely think that's going to be one, like, common way to stop it. I think an even more common way would actually be to try and go for, like, a double or triple grenade. I mean, it's always a question, is it worth it to allow them to get on the site so you can grenade down the bomb right. planner? But I think it definitely can work.
Well, it's usually smoked, so that Molotov won't always
exactly.
work. So, you're right, the triple nade might be better, and I mean, it's just hard sometimes. Oh, look at this pop flash, Cyber Focus, he spots the shoulder. I don't think he knows that one player got to the right, but now he's got a good angle, and he takes out Chris. Nicely done by him.
Yeah, and because Mousesports won that last round with one person alive, it means the Flipside win it now. I mean, they're almost going to get closed out of the game. It's not like Flipside have a lot of money, but they have a lot more rounds to work off of. This is kind of a disaster for Mousesports. And it's not entirely clear. There are some maps where if you're one or two people down on the T side, you will always want to go, like, on Inferno. You will always want to go B if you're a couple of people down playing T side. But on this map, kind of hard to know exactly where you end up at.
Yeah, it is. This can be a very tricky map to find entries, and that's basically what you need in this situation. You need some player to go huge and grab one or two to start the bomb site off, but we'll let it drop Speedy, and there goes those hopes and dreams. He does get a second one as well, so you're right, this is just an absolute worst case scenario for Mousesports right now.
Next, last man alive, nobody even dying on Flipside at the moment, and also time has run out, so no chance for any kind of miracle either. He does get a good headshot there on Blade, not sure how he managed to do that, but he's going to be the only one left, ends up dropping, and it's going to be 14-9. If you go to the B bomb side, are you also seeing this weird... Oh, it disappeared in the round, but there was like a weird... Almost like a riot shield in the middle of the B bomb side going on. there's like a window stuck in the ground.
I see it in chat. I didn't notice it myself. Is it still there?
No, it disappeared on the round restart. I was getting worried. You know, you have those like instant flashbacks, like riot shields breaking
their
turn.
Oh, God. Talk about the worst couple months of your Counter-Strike life.
That was truly awful, and I never figured out what the actual mechanics of the riot shield were, because I swear you could be shooting at people all day and then suddenly something would connect.
Like, you could shoot their feet, I know that.
Yeah, but even shooting like in the middle of it, sometimes it would just work and sometimes it wouldn't. It was really confusing. Either way, this is a pistol round coming out, or a bit of a force-up. Cyber Focus two really good kills there, not wasting a lot of time. I mean, I guess if you're going to have a stand-in for Simple, it's nice to have someone who can still play with the AWP, and Cyberfocus is doing super well at the moment here. 23 kills on him, Bondic at 27, definitely doing a great job as a stand-in, and Goppy, last man standing. This is going to be map point for Flipside.
Yeah, it really comes down to Mousesports not being able to do anything really against the AWPer. You know, they haven't been able to neutralize him. They haven't been able to pick him off or get him. I mean, this is just kind of very interesting because North American teams playing this map, they like to get aggressive in the bathroom, like I said earlier, and even sometimes down the stairs. We haven't, I mean, European teams also like to get aggressive down the stairs. We haven't seen too much of that. Flipside's kind of choosing to really put an emphasis on this long A route, you know, pushing up towards the tree there, that round where Bondic was so close for that quick flank. And I mean, here they go again. They have two players pushing up. Cyberfocus, Bondic's going to boost him up with the AWP and then push up towards the tree again. So, very interesting to me.
Blade not quite connecting with the spray through, and Markolov playing on the slope over at B. Good flashbang through. Chris trying to push it in. Delivers the bomb right to Markolov. And look at the rotation up on the minimap. All of Flipside instantly getting the memo. Action at B. The bomb is here as well. World that it will go down, and Markolov is going to fall as well. Cyberfocus missing a shot then. Maybe a chance here to extend the match a little bit for the Mousesports team. Blade trying to take a fight with Dennis, has to reload eventually. And backup's coming in from behind. Bondic with that Molotov, or sorry, that grenade kind of making it known that he's there. And is now just waiting, gonna smoke up behind him. He's got a Molotov as well to try and buy even more time. Gobby, gotta be careful. Yeah, here's the Molotov coming out, but it's a little bit too short. Bit of surprise that he didn't get that shot in. And Mousesports is playing this one super patiently. They really, really want Flipside to make a mistake.
Yeah, but Cyberfocus is loving this slow play with his AWP. Because, I mean, look, they have no nades or anything to block him off. So he's going to have a turkey shoot as soon as someone shows his face. Oh, he does get dinked through the floor, though. Gob gives him a little treat. And look at how low they are. It's going to be a lot of work on Bondic here to be first contact. They know exactly where he is. Nex is going to get the 1D. Pre-fires it.
Well, good shot there. You can't really shoot through that box, and you don't have any grenades to deal with Goppy either. He can stay there all day, and Dennis is in a great position. Look at this. Perfect lineup. If Goppy just doesn't show himself, there's nothing they could do about it. They have to come in to Dennis Crossfire, and as you said, they're so low. This looks like Mousesports may have done it. Cyberfocus has to run away, but they won't even allow him to. What an unlikely round win here for the Mousesports team. That's huge.
Yeah, they just use those Tech Nines to swarm that bomb site, and it's interesting. They've struggled to get the entries with their AKs on that B site, but the Tech Nines there worked wonders for him. Pick up some guns and set up a nice defense. And you're right. I mean, here's the thing: that flank from Bondic would have been perfect if Mousesports hadn't slowed down like that. You said it, and it looked a little bit scary at times, but they slowed things down to make sure they weren't going to get gimmicked like that from Bondic. So played it very well. Now we have Blade pushing down into those sewers.
Yeah, last time he sort of got zoned out and they just ran through the smoke. This time he's a little bit more proactive, trying to see if he can move up here. Going right in, looking in the pipes. I think he must have seen a couple of feet then. Is he actually going to connect all the way up with Markolov here? Almost looked like they could have double-teamed whoever came out of those pipes there, but just going to miss them by a couple of seconds. Chris jumping and scouting in the background. He actually wanted to catch World Edit. Such a tricky player, Chris.
He said he's the Scoutmaster.
Yeah, I mean, definitely the guy who sort of coined the whole jump scout a long time ago. There's Blade going down as well. World that it will fall. Look at Mousesports making their way through. Double on Gobby, double on Chris, and Bondic coming up from behind. Would have been great if he could have been here 10 seconds ago, but now he's alone in a 1v3. It could be that Mousesports could bring this back to overtime.
Yeah, well, this is the way to do it, because if they hold off this retake from Bondic, he is going to get the first one. He's got two more to find. Oh, he's just going to go for the smoke defuse. This could be very, very scary. Oh, he gets off it, though.
Runs out. Got the pistol out as well. Fighting Gobby. He's going to take it. If he goes for it now, Chris has to run. Otherwise, there's not going to be time. Oh, no, Chris. He doesn't make the jump. And Bondic is going to win it. What a round. What a clutch from Bondic. That is world class right there. I'm